obviously, now that the president has accepted that there is indeed a need, it means we'll begin to go to work. And it's at the end of the work that I believe that an appointment will be made. And what is that work? We need to draw up what are the core responsibilities of the Surgeon General, having accepted that principle. Mark you, the Nigerian Medical Association have been asking for this for decades. Mm. So so it's not a new thing. But I think there are areas that are where we actually have some lacuna. Take for instance, we have been talking about government sponsoring public servants for treatment abroad. Presently, we have a mechanism in the public service. It's either eventually the ultimate approval is given by the head of service or is given by the secretary to the government of the federation, depending on whether you're a core civil servant or you're a political appointee, like a minister. But I think government is beginning to feel that there's need for an office that is removed from politics, that may even require the Senate, for instance, approving, or maybe the rest, the whole of the National Assembly, to which everybody will know that we can direct such requests. And such office will be able to say, why can't this be treated in Nigeria? Why must it go outside? There are places where this can be treated. So that is one possible function of the Surgeon General if it's eventually filled as a position. The other thing, I'm sure you're all aware as media people about controversies that have arisen in trying to implement some of the provisions of our constitution. When the constitution says that either the president or governor could be relieved of his position if indeed he's no more in sound health, who decides that a governor is in sound health? There may be need for such an independent office established by the constitution or by law that should be able to handle that. So these are some of the reasons why we feel there is some gap to be filled. For how it is going to be filled has been the debate over the years. And also remember the questions as to whether the Minister of Health ought to be a medical doctor or not. Why can't he be someone who read English, or who read mass communication, or who read history? For you to have such, then you must be like other countries that have an office that is independent, that handles some specific issues and matters of public health professionally. So that the minister concentrates on purely administration and political decisions.